Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael, the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Luis,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the feast of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Eternal High Priest. And in this Mass, we join Jesus in offering himself as a holy and pleasing sacrifice to the Father, so that we may become less unworthy to participate in this Eucharist. Let us now humbly call to mind our sins and entrust ourselves to God's merciful love. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who for the glory of your majesty and the salvation of the human race, made your only begotten Son the eternal High Priest, grant that through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, those whom he has chosen as ministers and stewards of his mysteries may be found faithful in carrying out the ministry they have received. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Every priest stands daily at his service, offering repeatedly the same sacrifices, which can never take away sins. But when Christ had offered for all time a single sacrifice for sins, he sat down at the right hand of God, then to wait until his enemies should be made a stool for his feet. For by a single offering, he has perfected for all time those who are sanctified. And the Holy Spirit also bears witness to us, for after saying, "This is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, says the Lord, I will put my laws on their hearts and write them on their minds." Then he adds, "I will remember their sins and their misdeeds no more." When there is forgiveness of this, there is no longer any offering for sin. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek.
You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek.
The Lord's revelation to my Lord, sit at my right hand, until I make your foes your footstool.
You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek.
The Lord will send from Zion your scripture of power, rule in the midst of your foes.
You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek.
With you is princely rule, on the day of your power, to holy splendor from the womb before the dawn, I have begotten you.
You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them and said, "Take, this is my body." And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I say to you, I shall not drink again of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today a rather new feast in our liturgical calendar, a feast that is celebrated on the Thursday after Pentecost Sunday, the feast of our Lord Jesus Christ, the eternal High Priest. And the focus of this feast is Jesus as priest, the priesthood of Jesus Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, the title priest is something that was not immediately associated to Jesus, especially in the Gospels. Never in the Gospels was Jesus given the title priest. Jesus was a well-known teacher. He was a healer. He was called the Son of God, the Son of Man. He was called Lord. He was called Savior, Messiah. But only in the letter to the Hebrews could we see that Jesus is called a priest. Jesus was not considered a priest during his time because he did not come from the priestly clan. He was not a Pharisee. But is Jesus really a priest? If we look at the Old Testament, one of the important and primary functions of a priest is to offer sacrifice for the forgiveness of sins. That is why in our first reading today from the letter to the Hebrews, we are told that every year, the priest would stand before the altar of God to offer sacrifices for the forgiveness of sins. He would offer sacrifices on behalf of the people. And usually, when we talk of sacrifices in the Old Testament, the sacrifice was an animal. But Jesus also made a sacrifice for the forgiveness of our sins. And the sacrifice of Jesus is unique because the sacrifice of Jesus is his own body and blood. That made the offering of Jesus for the forgiveness of sins unique. Jesus, as priest, made the offering, but Jesus, the priest, is also the offering. If in the past, there's a difference between the priest and the sacrifice being offered by the priest, In Jesus, the priest and the sacrifice become one. Jesus is the priest who offers, and Jesus is the Holocaust, the offering being sacrificed to God. And because of that, the offering of Jesus is most pleasing to the Father, because it is the sacrifice of His own life. That is why we heard in our gospel today, Jesus telling His disciples, "This is my body, this is my blood of the new covenant poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins." And so Jesus is truly a priest. He is a priest like no other. He is a priest, the eternal high priest. My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus gives us a new meaning to priesthood. Priesthood is not just about offering sacrifices. Priesthood is about offering oneself as a sacrifice to the Father. And this priesthood of Jesus has been shared to all of us. In baptism, we were made sharers in this one priesthood of Christ. By virtue of baptism, all of us are priests. Dahil tayo'y bininyagan, tayo'y nakabahagi sa pagkapari ni Jesus. Kaya kapag sinabi nating pari, hindi lamang yun kami na naordinan bilang pari. Lahat tayo bilang mga binyagan ay pari dahil nakikibahagi tayo sa pagkapari ni Jesus. We as priests are called ordained ministers, but all of us, by virtue of baptism, share in the common priesthood. We share in the one priesthood of Christ. Kaya sa ating buhay, kapag ginagawa natin ang pag-aalay sa Diyos, ipinapakita rin natin yung ating pagkapari. When we are willing to make sacrifices for others, we exercise our priesthood. When we let go of comforts in order to help other people, when we are willing to undergo some forms of suffering, inconvenience for the good of other people, then we manifest our priesthood, the priesthood of Christ, which we become sharers of. Sa ating ginagawa araw-araw, kapag nagiging mapagbigay tayo, inuuna ang iba kaysa sa sarili. Kapag tayo'y naglilingkod sa ating kapwa, kapag tayo'y tumutulong sa nangangailangan, yan ang pagpapahayag ng ating pagkapari. Ang pari hindi lamang yung nasa altar. Tayong lahat, kahit sa tahanan, sa ospital, sa trabaho, sa lipunan, pwede tayong magpakita ng ating pagkaparing pakikibahagi sa pagkapari ni Jesus. If we offer ourselves as a sacrifice for other people, then we become priests who offer ourselves as a pleasing offering to God. My dear brothers and sisters, as we exalt today our Lord Jesus Christ, the eternal high priest, let us thank Him for sharing His priesthood to us. And today, and every day of our lives, may we always offer ourselves as a holy and pleasing offering to the Father. On the night before his death, Jesus sat at table with his disciples, gathered to celebrate the sacred supper. Let us join Christ and pray to the Father for all our needs. For every petition, let us say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church on earth, that we may be guided to a greater understanding of the perfect love and service of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in possessions of power and influence in the world, that they may understand something of the spirit of Christ's sacrifice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those confronted by temptation, that they may be strengthened by Christ's example of loyalty to his Father, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us in this community, that more and more we may reflect in our lives the Eucharistic love of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the dead, that the sacrifice of the Eucharist may bring them to eternal life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our own petitions. Let us pray for the people who need our prayers and the intentions offered in this Mass. Father, we come before you and present our needs to you, humbled by the Eucharistic love and generosity of your Son, our eternal priest, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord, may our mediator Jesus Christ render these gifts acceptable to you, and may he present us as sacrifices pleasing to you in union with him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son High Priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous design were pleased to decree that this one priesthood should continue in the Church. For Christ not only adorns with the royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the Paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word, and strengthen them with the sacraments. as they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters. They strive to be conformed to the image of Christ Himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Broderick our Administrator and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Father as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress,
as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Act of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
We stand before the crowd. Faithfully yours until the end, to your nation, Lord, we give our yes.